So today's going to be a little change of pace. I'm actually going to do a hair video for you. And I'm going to be showing you how to bleach your hair to get it this nice bright white color, hopefully without damaging it too much. So yeah, I'll show you all the products that I use. I'm going to go into detail on the exact quantity amounts. That way you could go home, do your own calculations, and utilize it in the best way. And I will be talking about actual bleaching, toning, and then a little bit of aftercare as far as what to use. So the video is going to be kind of long. I'm going to be giving you a lot of detailed information. Keep in mind, a huge disclaimer, by no means am I saying to go home and throw a bucket of bleach on your head, let it sit, and then hope that your hair doesn't fall out. Just, if you haven't bleached your hair before, or if you have doubts, or if you're not comfortable doing it, totally either ask someone that is an actual professional, or what I really recommend doing is going and getting it done by someone the first time. So go to your hairdresser, or find a good hairdresser, and pay that one time, and then take notes, or pay attention to what they're doing, and then if you think it's something that you feel comfortable doing, then you can go home and do it yourself. But if you've never done this before, I don't really recommend jumping into bleach as a way to start your hair dyeing process. Also, another disclaimer is I am not a hairdresser. I'm not trying to be one. I'm not pretending to be one. I'm letting you know now. So if you have detailed questions, I mean, you can totally ask me what you want. But for example, if you say, my hair color is this shade, what exactly would I need to use to get here? I'm not going to be able to tell you. Also because I can't actually see it and I can't actually feel it. But those sort of questions I can't help you with. I will, however, let you know that I have been doing hair for about 13 years. Yeah. I was taught by hairdressers at a very young age how to do hair, and I was actually doing my mother's hair when I was very young, and I was always taught the professional way and the right way to use it. I've always used professional products, and what I mean by that is I wasn't taught how to go to Target and buy a box hair color and put it on. I was taught how to do highlights and lowlights. That was actually the very first thing that I was taught how to do with the mixing of the actual, you know, the products and the colorants and such. So It's something I've been doing for a long time, so bleach is not a big deal. I've been platinum before. It's totally nothing. But if you're not somebody that has been doing that, it can get super scary. So, yeah. Again, I'll be going into detail into quantities. So if you want to know exactly how much, just rewind the video. That way you can see it. I'm not going to list everything underneath because for people it's going to be different. And that, I think, is it. So to start off, we're going to start with the products used for bleaching. What to use to bleach, and this is again to get more of this bright white. I will say this, my hair right now, one, it's not brushed because I just got back from class, hence the, you know, the little beanie, but I also just used a not so awesome shampoo yesterday, and I did not condition because I'm going to be changing my hair color, so that's why I'm doing the video right now. So your hair can get a lot softer than this. Right now mine does not feel, I mean, it's okay, but it could totally be better. But I'll be showing you the correct stuff to use. And yeah, so the products that I'm going to be using, everything that I'm going to be using except for the actual shampoos is going to be from Redken. Now, I know some of you are like, well, dude, I can't get Redken because I'm not professional, whatever, and I can't get into the legit stores. Just take what I'm teaching you or showing you and go to a Sally's or go to something and get an equivalent. So, for example, I'm going to say, hey, I'm using the Redken 40 volume. Well, you can go, okay, cool, I know what this is. This is a 40 volume. Go to Sally's and get their 40 volume. See what I'm saying? That's how it's going to be. To buy Redken, you do have to be an actual, you know, you got to be legit. You have to have a card. You have to go into the store and you have to buy it that way. So just keep that in mind. If you're able to do that, then you can just go buy all these products. If you can't, find a friend maybe that can help you out. Or again, just find the equivalent. So there you go. So to do the actual bleaching, the products that you're going to use are bleach. And again, this is from Redken. This is up to 7. This is a ginormous size. As you can see, I do lots of bleaching. If you get this one, when you pop it open, the bleach is in little baggies, you empty it in, and there you go. And it also comes with scoops. So open that up. Don't break this stuff in. So opening this up away from my face. See the little scoopies? You only get one, but I had another one from a past little container, so I wanted to throw them both in there. So Redken up to 7. This is going to be your powder, okay? And then Redken 40 volume. Oops, that way. Okay, and that's going to be your liquid. 40 is the highest volume, okay? 10, 20, 30, 40 is what you're looking at. This is going to be the strongest. That doesn't necessarily mean that's what you should use. Keep in mind, my hair is insanely thick, So it honestly can do anything. It loves me. It's great. But you may not need to use a 40 volume. If you're unsure, again, talk to your hairdresser, see what they're using. Or if you're going to go into a Sally's or something like that, ask them. Show them your hair and say, hey, dude, this is my hair color. I'm trying to get here. What should I do? And they'll help you out. Hopefully they know what's going on. But these are the products that you're going to want to mix together. Another little hidden surprise product, which is like, this is an awesome, awesome, awesome little secret. Tell all your friends. Let them know I told you. You don't have to. But is to mix sugar in with the product. Sugar, like, that you eat, you know. You can use Splenda, or you could use the stuff I use, True something. It's got, like, a leaf. But you can totally use that. There's a little bit of a reaction that happens, which is kind of cool. And what it does is when you apply bleach to your scalp, it's going to burn. Just straight up, it's going to burn. It'll itch. Something's going to happen. When you put the sugar in, it neutralizes everything. So it basically, it just takes everything and there's no burn, there's no tingling, there's no nothing. If you do it the first time and you feel like there's still a burning, add more sugar. So, yay, that'll be super helpful. Okay. Anyway, back to this. You want to take these two things and you want to mix equal parts, one to one. Does that make sense? So if you're going to put 2 ounces of this, you want 2 scoops of this, okay? To do that, make sure you have a mixing bowl. And you can get, there's super cute ones too at Sally's if you want to get something better. But a mixing bowl. And make sure you have a little brush, well, a bigger brush. And something to measure with. This measures ounces and milliliters, okay? So that's how you're going to get your ratio. So take, for example, I always do the powder first. Take your powder. For me to do my roots, and I'm talking when I've got like a tiny, tiny little bit, because I do it all the time, I actually use 4 to 5 scoops of this to 4 to 5 ounces, which I know is an insane amount, but my hair is very thick. So again, don't start out with that. Start out with like 2 and see where to go. So for me, I would take 4 to 5 ounces of this, pour it in here. Take about, I don't know, 2 tablespoons sugar, pour it in there. 4 to 5 ounces of liquid that I measured with my little guy, and pour it in here. Then you want to mix it. I like to take this end, stir, 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 take the other end, stir, stir, stir. You basically want to mix it to where there aren't any more, there's no more powder, similar to when you bake a cake. So just mix, mix, mix. And when you're ready, you're going to go ahead and take that and apply it to the scalp. I'll very briefly show you how to do that. I will make a video later on whenever I'm doing my bangs and such. But, well, I'll show you. My hair's a mess. Like I said, I haven't brushed it or anything. This is in here. You want to grab a little bit. Oh, and I apologize. Make sure you have gloves on when you do this. And section your hair however you'd like. Everybody does it totally different. I normally section a couple pieces across here and kind of down the middle. But if, say, this was your section here, take this end, go up a little bit, bleach, 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 same thing, up a little bit, bleach, 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 etc. If you're doing this all over for the first time, bleach it, and then do little sections. The best thing, though, is just to work in little parts. You don't want to just slop it on. Then once that's on, go ahead and either put like a shower cap on, or you can take a saran wrap if you don't have a shower cap on you. Wrap it around and then let it sit for approximately 35 minutes. You can let it sit a little bit longer. I normally do mine for about 45. It's going to be like a pale yellow color. You're not at this point trying to bleach it to where it turns white. Mine actually gets really close to white, but even if you're in that pale yellow range, it's totally fine. That's what toner's for, and that's what I'll be showing you after that. So again, equal parts powder, mix everything, stick it on the scalp, let it sit for about 35 to 45 minutes. Okay, so now onto the toner, and this is where it gets kind of fun and also extremely confusing if you haven't done hair before. Toner, basically what it does is this is what you're going to use after you're done with the bleaching. So you took a shower, you did the bleaching, you let it sit 35 to 45 minutes. Now you're going to want to hop in the shower and you're going to want to rinse everything with a shampoo. Not a conditioner, not a shampoo-conditioner combo, just a shampoo and do it twice. One time, scrub everything, and then a second time, just to really make sure that you got all the bleach off. And at this point, your hair is going to be wet because you used water. And you're going to want to at least towel dry it a little bit. That's at least this is what I do. I just towel dry it a little bit. You don't really want it too dry. And just kind of take a comb, like a wide tooth comb, and just kind of work it through. And you're going to now tone it. So say your hair is like this weird pale yellow color. Don't freak out yet. You have to tone it. So this is what's going to help. Now, I will say, though, if you're super dark, like black, and you're going blonde, it's going to take a couple stages, so just keep that in mind. So, toners, there's a bunch of different ones you can use. Again, I'm using the Redken, and I'll show you what I use, and then you can go from there. You're going to need a little bottle guy like this. Okay, you're going to need a little bottle guy like this. This is what you're going to fill up, and this actually has measurement marks, again, in ounces. It's going to be very hard to see, but if you have an idea. This is what you're going to use to measure to do the toning. You are also going to need processing solution. Okay, and this is from Redken. All the toning products are the Shades EQ products that I'm using, so this is the processing solution. Now, for me to get my hair this color, this is what I use, and there's a bunch of different ones you can use. I use the Shades EQ Conditioning Gloss. So this is in Crystal Clear. This is their 00. And this kind of helps to dilute the product down a little bit. And then I also use their Shades EQ... Yeah, it's basically their 9V and Platinum Ice. Okay. There's other ones you can use. I use a 9V because that's how I get this particular shade of blonde, and that's what I like. You can use titaniums. You can use blues. I mean, there's so many options of toners, and again, that's why it's better to go to someone and give them an idea of what you want, and then they'll tell you what to use. Different toners will give you different shades. That's why if you ever look at blondes, they're not all the same. You can line them up. Some look like they have more gray, some look like they have more blue, some have more purple, some have more white, some have a little bit of yellow. There's so many different tints. So that's where this all comes in. Again, I'll tell you exactly what I use. If you want to 100% copy and replicate it, it's cool. You can go do what you want. Send me a photo. So for the toner, in this little guy, you're going to want to open this up. I just cleaned this, so that's why that's hanging out in there. And look at this measurement on here on the ounces. And you're going to want to start with, or at least this is what I start with, is this stuff, okay? This is that 9V that I was talking about. So with the 9V, you want to fill up 1.5 ounces. Again, this is for my hair, so just keep this in mind. 1.5 ounces of 9V. That is not going to be this whole bottle. I believe it's going to be almost 3/4. So 1.5 ounces of 9V goes directly in here. And it has a slight hue to it, a slight color, but it's not too strong. So just, it's totally normal. Just put it in the bottle. And then after that, you're going to want to take the Crystal Clear guy, and you're going to want to put in 1 ounce to this, okay? 1 ounce. And I'll go over this again at the end in this guy. Then you're going to want to take the processing solution and put 2.5 ounces in. Again, pour it right in here, just one right on top of the other. When you're all done, you should have 5 ounces of product. Okay, so let me go through that again. 1.5 ounces of 9V, 1 ounce Crystal Clear, 2.5 ounces processing solution. Did I do that right? Yeah. Put it in here, close your little lid up, squeeze this just a little bit, and this is why I was taught by one of my hairstylist friends. Put your finger on the top, it's going to stay like that, and shake it. Reason why you want to do this is because if you don't close it, you go like this, and you shake it, and you open it, it's going to spurt out. So just takes a little bit of the air out. Shake it. Shake it thoroughly, I don't know, 30 seconds or so. You'll look, and you'll see. And then let it chill. Just let it sit just for a little bit. At this point, you know, maybe start brushing your hair out with a comb or something. You're going to see this slowly change color. It's going to look this weird gray-green, and then it's going to look purple. Somewhere within that stage, you want to start using this. If you let this sit out for too long and then you go to use it, it's not going to do anything. So just wait, I don't know, the 30 seconds and then start using it. It's not insanely time-sensitive or time-crucial, so it's not like after 45 seconds it doesn't work anymore, but don't let it chill there and forget about it and be like, oh, dude, I got to go tone. It doesn't work that way. So then, sorry, I'll show you on here again. You're going to want to, I always kind of, my hair just parts naturally now, but part your hair however you normally would. take this and kind of work it through the hair. So as you're going back, you're squeezing and going back and squeezing and going back and squeezing and going, okay, does that make sense? And then I like to take the hair that's out and kind of run down and through and then work through. Do that all over your entire head. And then take that wide-toothed comb again and just kind of work through. Or you can use your fingers. You're just more accurate whenever you use the comb. And then let that sit. You want to let it sit for about a minute. Your hair is going to look very scary at this point. If you look directly in a mirror, it's going to look gray. It's going to look purple. You're going to think you ruined everything. Oh my God, why did you do it? That's fine. Just let it sit. Again, only about a minute. The longer you leave this on, the more violet, because this is 9V, which is violet, the more violet your hair will be. So if you're using a different color combination, it's going to grab more of this color. The less you leave it on, the less violet it's going to be. So if you want it to be more in this whitish tone, just about a minute's going to be fine. It's going to neutralize the yellow, and that's it. So once that is done, rinse out your hair, just rinse everything through. You can use cold water if you want to, you know, whatever. Rinse everything through, and then I put a conditioner on because you want to go ahead and condition. And your hair is going to smell amazing, or at least I think it does. I love the freaking smell of toner. I love it. But yeah, just rinse it through. And your hair is probably going to look a little strange still, but once you blow dry it, or dry it, or let it air dry, whatever you want to do, that's where you're going to get more of this color that's coming through. Does that make sense? Hopefully. So that's the bleaching. That's the toning. And now I'm going to show you just a few products that you can use for aftercare. So the head is back on, because nobody needs to see that. But I'm going to talk to you just about a few products that you can use for aftercare to keep up with the color and, you know, make sure your hair's still doing okay and you're not killing it. First off is make sure you're using a good shampoo and conditioner. Oddly enough, with my hair, I normally use the Big and Sexy line. Love it. But when my hair is bleached, it doesn't work that well with it. And again, this is just my hair. And I have actually found through using multiple different things over the years, my hair actually really likes the cheap Pantene. When it's bleached, I know there's a lot of dimethicone in there, which makes everything feel nice and silky, but my hair loves it. So it's kind of nice. I bleach my hair and I'm paying for the bleaching, but then I don't have to spend as much on the whatever stuff. So, you know. So I just use Pantene. I use the Breakage to something I think they came out with recently. Breakage to Healthy. I don't know. But I use that shampoo and I use that conditioner. Now, when your hair is bleached, you know, platinum, you do want to make sure you maintain it, though, even when you're washing it. So you want to mix it in with a blue or a purple shampoo. Blues are next to impossible to find. I'm just going to let you know. You can find them. Most of the time it's online unless you're lucky enough to have some place that has it. Purples are the most convenient. So that's actually what I use because that's, you know, works for me anyway. But if you can't find a blue, don't freak out. Just get a purple. You'll be okay. The one that I've used for a long time is this stuff right here. This is from Joico. It's called their Color Endure, and it is a violet shampoo. See that? Violet shampoo. Okay. This is okay. I don't know. It's okay. I don't know. Their shampoo is just kind of thick. Like, it's more, it's not like a gel. It's just thicker, so I don't really dig it so much, because sometimes it can make my hair, it weighs my hair down a little bit. I don't know, but that's what I use because I went out and I bought a huge bottle. So I just finished that and I recently just switched to the L'Oreal colors. Now this is what you get at an actual pro, again, makeup or a pro hair place. So I don't know that you could get this wherever, but you could go, just go into a Sally's again, go into an Ulta, go into, I don't know if Sephora sells hair stuff. But you can go in there and they sell violet shampoo. Like, you can literally walk in and just say, I need a violet or I need a purple shampoo. And they'll go, well, we've got about 20 different ones. What do you want? So there's lots of options. So just remember that. But you're going to want to do that. It's kind of up to you. Maybe about once a week, depending upon how much you wash your hair. I wash my hair too much. I know that. But I like it to be clean. What I actually do is I have a separate bottle, like a smaller size bottle, in my shower that I mixed. It's half my regular Pantene shampoo and then half of the L'Oreal. Shake it all together so it's more of a diluted form of this. You do want to be careful if you use these purples straight. and you bleach your hair or you freshly bleached your hair, the colorant is going to deposit more. So you may be left with blue or you may be left with purple hair. If you mix it in with a shampoo, you're not going to have that issue or you're not going to have as much of that issue. And you can leave that on. Like, I'll actually shampoo it and leave it on for about 5 minutes while I do, you know, some other stuff. And then rinse it out. So do that, rinse it out, and then follow it up with a good conditioner. Pantene just works, dude. So I use the Pantene conditioner. Let that sit. You can also use a very nice mask. Masks are awesome. I love them, and I literally just ran out of my other one. I just went to go check, and I saw it in the trash, which means I ran out of it. The one that I like to use is actually sold at Ulta's. I don't know where else you can get it. It's a macadamia one. It's just a macadamia mask. I wish I could give you more info, but I can't remember right now. If you go into an Ulta and ask, you can see. But any sort of masks or conditioning treatments, however you want to label it, work really well in the hair. Then I get out, and then when my hair is wet, I spray it with a detangler. See? Pantene told you. Oh, medium. But I just spray it with a detangler. And that's just going to help, because if you start bleaching your hair, if you over bleach it or something, you don't want to accidentally brush and then rip out a bunch. So just detangle it, and that way you don't have to worry about it. I let that sit, and then I also use this right here. It's from Proclaim. I actually got this at Sally's. I love this stuff. I know some people don't like it, but it works really well. It's a color and heat protection, and it's also a gloss and polish. So basically what you can use while your hair is wet, you can really work it through the hair. It's going to soak in. It's going to leave everything nice and soft. When your hair dries, whether you blow dry it or let it dry naturally, it's really shiny. And then it's protected from heat. So if you need to flat iron, if you need to do anything like that, which when you're bleaching, it's super important to protect. And that's kind of it. I know it's a lot, but once you get the hang of it, it really doesn't take that long. I know this video took a long time, but once you get the hang of doing everything, it really doesn't take that long. You kind of just get into it. Like, you know, one night could just go and be like, oh, dude, I need to bleach my hair. Do, and then you go about your business. But yeah, so that's everything. Again, when I need to bleach again, I will make a video. I'm going to remember to do one. That way you can see exactly how to apply it. But again, that's not going to be for some time. So if you're like itching to bleach something right now, hopefully this will help you out a little bit. So you've got all the instructions, got all, you know, the stuff to do it, and you've got all the measurements, at least that I used to get this. And I believe that is all. Yeah. Awesome. Okay. Well, if you guys have questions, again, go ahead and let me know, and then I will see you all next time. Bye.